Would you like to see how a property management service company would set up a file in QuickBooks? Well, then you need to watch this video. Set up a QuickBooks file for a property management service company. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. It's very easy to set up a QuickBooks file for a property management service company. Some will be basic QuickBooks setup steps to prepare a file the way you would for any company. But some steps will be specific to a property management company to give that type of company exactly what they need during the setup. Each step has its own separate video in the basic tutorial series if you want to know a little more about each step. However, we will only do the specific steps in each case to prepare a file for our type of company, meaning we will only show in this video series exactly what steps to take to set up a file for property management services. So what are the first two steps in setting up a QuickBooks company file for a property management company? Well, first you have to physically create the file in the way the property management service company needs. Then you will have to set the preferences in the file that will help the property management service company record transactions in the unique way that they need to. And you may well ask, what is a property management company file? Well, very simply put, it's a data file in the computer represented by an icon just like a Microsoft Word document file or an Excel file or any other file you can copy to a USB stick or send as an email attachment. All of your financial information is in that one file represented by that one icon. So make sure you keep it safe and make sure it can be easily copied to anywhere after we create it. So, when you set up the file, just answer the same questions that QuickBooks is asking us in the way that we answer it, and your file will be created properly. Just follow step by step and do exactly as I show. So, very simple. In the top left of your QuickBooks, even if you have a company open, it won't matter. There will always be in the top left a file menu where you can click New Company. Now, you want to choose For Myself and then click Start Setup. And of course, if you have an older version or a newer version, it might look slightly different, but the idea will be the same. Now, you might be able to get away with clicking Sign In Later, and if you can't see this, but if you click Sign In Later, you can go down and click 2 days, and it'll remind you in 2 days, but it won't force you to sign in right away. Now, our example company name will be Pamela Property Management Co. And of course, we would put in the address, the name, and the phone number, and so on in a real situation. But the only two mandatory fields, or third field, that you must put is click Industry Help Me Choose, scroll all the way down, and click Other None. This is because none of these general ledger or chart of account options fit for a management service company. So we choose Other None, and in the next video, we'll put it together ourselves. We should also, for business type, click Help Me Choose, and click Other None, and click OK. That's because every company has a different equity structure, and your accountant will help you determine that. Now, email address, you can just put, as long as you put something, QuickBooks will allow you to save the file. Now, of course, in a real situation, you would fill in the rest of the address information and business information, but we're going to leave it blank for now so I can show you the way to go back to it and put it in or change it after the file is created. Click. Now, do not click Create Company. What you have to do is click Preview Your Settings. Preview Your Settings. You see, you must preview your settings in order to be able, you must preview your settings in order to be able to determine where the computer physically creates and places the file, meaning the location of the file, and so forth, meaning what folder it'll belong to. So we will click Preview Your Settings, and we will click Company File Location. Click Change Location, and in our example, choose the desktop. If you have a specific folder in mind, that's fine, but I like to choose the desktop and click OK. And now I know after I click Create Company, that folder with this name, or excuse me, that QuickBooks file with this name will be on the desktop. Click Create Company. When it's done, you can minimize and check your desktop to make sure the icon for the file that you just created is right there, exactly the location you chose. When it's finished, you can go ahead and click Start Working, and you will see the rest of the QuickBooks file is ready. You know, you close some of the pop-up windows because they always want to show you the new features and so on. But you should see Pamela's name across the top, and you should be able to minimize this and find the file on your desktop. So what's the second step? Well, we want to be able to go back and change the address that we failed to put in during the setup. So let's put in 6161 Southwoods Road, Huntington, 11995. How do you do that? Well, you do that by going to the My Company window. See, My Company window. Watch. Company, My Company. And in the My Company window, you can click the pencil tool and you will have the ability to put in the address. It's not a real address. Click OK. Click No. And there you have it. You were able to, and then you can click this and change it anytime you want if the company moves. That was the reason I skipped over it during the physical file setup. Now the next step we will do is set the preferences in this file. And you may well ask, what are preferences? The preferences are the settings, the defaults, the options. In other words, it's the automatic behavior of the software until you come and change the behavior yourself. It'll also determine what features are available that you can actually activate and add to the software from the preferences window. Now let's take a look at how to navigate the preferences window. From the top left, we click Edit, Preferences. You notice on the left there are different categories of preferences that you can click, and you'll also notice that each category of preference has a company preference tab and a my preference tab, and that's how you would navigate that window. And now we will set the specific preferences that a property management company, a service company that gives service to landlords, would need when setting the preferences. First, We want to turn off all the annoying pop-up messages for QuickBooks paid services. We don't need those. So we will click Accounting on top, then click Company Preferences. Actually, excuse me, we will click General. We click the General category. Then in the General category, we click My Preferences, and we click this check mark, Turn off pop-up messages for products and services, and click OK. Now we have to reopen the window for the next preference. Now, turn off date warning so we can put whatever date we want without being distracted. So, we can come to the accounting category of preference, click Company Preference, and click here to remove these two check marks. This way, if we're putting in example transactions, we won't get annoying pop-up messages that will distract us. Click OK. Now, we're going to change the payment settings so we're able to record direct deposits from both landlord and their tenants. So how do we do that? It's very simple. Click Edit, Preferences, go to the category of payments, and then click the Company Preference tab. Remove the check mark that says Use Undeposited Funds as a default deposit to account, and click OK. Okay, then click OK and everything closes and you're ready for the next one. We want to auto refresh reports. This means if a report is open and we make a transaction, we want the report to change immediately. So we click the category of reports and graphs and click refresh automatically and click OK. And the last preference we will set is don't save the open windows because that slows down QuickBooks when you're trying to quit. Edit, Preferences, Desktop View is the category. Remove Show the Home Page so you don't get distracted by the home page because we will not be using the home page as a property management service company. Instead, click the Company Preference. Stay on the My Preference and click Don't Save the Desktop. These two options will make things go much quicker if you specifically use QuickBooks for a property management company. Click OK, and then you are finished. Now you're ready for the next video, which will show you the final steps of the property management file setup.